Good morning, welcome to the river. One thing we're sure about at the River of Life, that the Holy Spirit moves, and He moves mightily. So just keep your eyes open and see how God moves in the service this morning. You're going to be blessed, and so are we.
Thank you, gracious Father, because nothing compares to who You are. We are so grateful for that. So Father, right now we just invite Your Holy Spirit into this service, into this building, into each and every heart that's here today, Heavenly Father. And Lord, just use me, Father, to share Your word so that, Lord, hearts will be changed, lives will be changed for Your glory, for Your kingdom, Father. Thank You for broken chains today in Jesus' name, Father. We're thanking You for freedom. Freedom comes from You, Heavenly Father, and we're here, we're ready. We're ready to go, Father. We're anticipating that You're going to move in a mighty way today. So, Father, we just love You and we praise You, and all God's people said,
amen.
Amen. Amen.
You may high-five somebody near you if you'd like. Holy Spirit, high-five. Amen. I'll sneak one in here. There it is. All right, hallelujah. Oh, morning, everybody. Morning, morning, morning. Hallelujah. All right. Just some stuff. God is good. Amen to that. He just shares things with you. Life stories, people around you, things that happen to us, whatever it may be. It's always a testimony. It's always a story because God is good. Amen to that. All right. If you want to turn your Bibles to Galatians chapter 5, we're going to start there. If somebody would holler out a page number, please. That'd be great. We're going to do some reading in here. I shared last time I was up front here, I shared part of Galatians, but it wasn't this part. This is the good stuff here. 1340, thank you. So we're going to start right in verse 1. I'm going to read a handful of verses right off the bat, and then we're going to talk about that and kind of move onward. I got a little story to tell and see where God takes it all. But God is in all things. Amen?
Amen.
Amen to that. So, all right. So chapter 5, verse 1. All right. Of course, Paul's writing this, and he tells us that in the second verse here. So chapter 5, stand fast, therefore, in the liberty by which Christ has made us free. He's made us free. When we accept Jesus Christ into our heart, He makes us free. We got to walk it out. Are we ready to walk it out today? Today's a new day. Today's freedom. Amen to that?
Amen.
Hallelujah. All right. And do not be entangled again. Listen to that. Do not be entangled again. What does that mean? Fall back. We fall back. Things happen. Whatever reason. You know, we can go back with a yoke of bondage. There's a lot of bondages. Each and every one of us has a different type of bondage. Amen? Because the devil knows where we're the weakest. And he'll just keep picking at us, picking at us. It's almost like a scab. It almost heals over and then he rips it off again. Well, we got to protect that so that he don't have that opportunity, so the devil can't get at that. Amen to that? Let's let that total healing take place so that we can do God's work then. Amen.
Amen.
All right. And then verse 2 says, indeed, I, Paul, say to you that if you have become circumcised, Christ will not profit you nothing. And I testify again to every man who becomes circumcised that he is a debtor to keep the whole law. You have became estranged from Christ, you who attempt to be justified by law. You have fallen from grace. That was the law back then, to be circumcised. And it, to God, that don't matter. That was the law. That was man's law, okay? But if you bow down to that, if you bow down to the way of man, which, of course, can be many. Way of man includes our flesh. If we bow down to our flesh, God even showed me this, if we become circumcised, what God was showing me is, you know what, that can be other things we struggle with. Not only flesh, but, you know, there's certain addictions, there's certain anger stuff that we go, you know, that's part of what man deals with, you know, and it's not law, but yet again, it's of the enemy. Enemy can work in that, and that we can fall into those positions in our life, and it's hard for us to get out. Amen to that. So it just talks about, if we say to you that if you become circumcised, Christ will not profit you nothing, because that was not of God. God didn't ask you to do that. Christ didn't ask you to do that. The Holy Spirit didn't prompt you to do that. And there's many things in our life that He don't prompt us to do things, but we take that step. We're not seeking the Spirit. We're trying to please the flesh. And when we do that, we're not in God's will.
It don't profit him at all. It don't profit God's kingdom. It's not where we want to be. We want it to be, get ourselves out of the way and let God work through us. Let it be to his glory. Because if it wasn't for Christ, we wouldn't be here. Amen. Amen to that. So let's whatever we do, let's have it so it's to Christ's glory. Amen. All right. For we, through the Spirit, eagerly wait for the hope of righteousness by faith. For in Christ Jesus, neither circumcision nor uncircumcision avails anything, but faith working through love. You ran well. Who hindered you from obeying the truth? Well, I think I summed it up in probably two words. I'm going to say the flesh has hindered me from walking where God wants me to walk. And that kind of brings me to where this is going, because we see a lot of fleshly things going on, whether they're Christians, whether they're not Christians, whatever it may be. And if the Holy Spirit's living in you, we should be grieved. And that's what I was grieved when I heard some situations. I was grieved. It's like, really? Why is that person doing that? But yet again, why have I done things like that too? So it brought me to the love of Christ. Because God loved me where I'm at. He loves each and every one of us where we're at. He's not going to let us down. He's never going to leave us nor forsake us. His word says that. We believe it. Amen to that. Amen. And just like I'm reading here, you know, we believe it. So you ran well. What hindered you from obeying the truth and getting back here, you know, entangled again? It's easy for us to fall back into that sin, fall back into that rut, fall back into an addiction, fall back into our language, whatever it may be. I know at work I got to be cautious because I get around certain, most of the men know where I'm at. And they'll change their language around me, and I praise them. I thank God for that. But yet again, there's some of them over there that really don't care. And it's so easy to kind of fall into that. I might not use the language, but all of a sudden I start picking on somebody or I start poking a stick at somebody. You know what I'm saying? It's like, why am I doing that? God loves that person as much as he loves me. Amen to that? So that's why we really need to focus, stay focused on him. Stay focused on that man right there, because he gave it all for us. Amen to that? So it's just something that we really need to focus on. Let me continue on my regarding when we see situations, when we do things, it grieves the Holy Spirit, and it should grieve us. And so when I hear other people or see other people or perhaps, you know, caught a glimpse of a story of something that really it wasn't very godly, something they were doing, it's like, especially if they know Christ, it's like, ah, you know. But that's where God asks us. We're going to talk about the fruits of the Spirit. That's where God asks us to step into the fruit of the Spirit so that we can love them unconditionally, just like Christ did for us. Amen? Amen. And we need to give it our all, because it's so easy just to shun them. As we were talking in Bible study, the last Bible study, you know, strong arm. We can strong arm God, and if we do that, that's not a good thing. We can strong arm other people too, because, well, they didn't do something we didn't like. You know what? We're just as guilty as they are. Let me put it to you that way. You know, they're not perfect, and neither are we. So we have to accept them right where they're at, just like Christ accepts us, just like God accepts us right where we're at. And so that's one awesome thing. There was a commercial way back when, reach out and touch someone. And the only thing I could think about was that was the old style telephones way back when they were, you know, old style. I'm talking, you know, the old spin around, reach out and touch someone. But I don't remember if that was the one, okay? But sometimes you would just like to reach out and touch someone. Like Pastor even shared the other day, you know, I'd like to touch you. Yeah, exactly. She did it before me. I was going to do it, okay? Yeah, you'd like to just grab them around the neck and just kind of help them out a little bit. You know what I'm saying? That's not nice. Because I would have been dead and gone a long time ago. Amen to that? God would have, yeah, taken me out. But he's merciful and graceful. Thank you, Jesus. Amen to that. I just want to, we're going to read, go down to verse 22 now. We're going to talk, we'll read the fruit of the Spirit. Let's read that on 22, still chapter 5, verse 22 now. And so it talks about the fruit of the Spirit. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. I like that part. There is no law. There is no law against none of that. You can't outlove anybody. You can't outforgive them. You can't out, you know, have enough mercies and grace of faith. You just can't. It ain't happening. There's no law against that. So you can just keep pushing forward in all them and keep spoiling people and keep loving on them and keep encouraging them. Just keep on. Just keep on. Amen to that. And that's when, you know, all this come about. You know, I'm thinking to myself, you know, this story that I heard or this person that I seen this do this, I need to love on them. I need to give them mercy and grace. I need to walk with them. I need to encourage them. It's okay. God forgives you and so do I, you know, depending on what the situation is. But yet again, they have to just take that step of faith. Our flesh is weak. And we're a lot of times when we're hurting, when we're looking for something that's not of God, our flesh will give in the first thing. It will usually give in first. And once that happens, we'll go down that slippery slope that the devil already had set up for us. Amen to that. So that's why we really need to know the difference between our spiritual and our flesh. We need that. You know, we're going to read about that here in a little bit. We need to be able to shut it down, not give our flesh any control over our life. God gives us that control. God gives us a free will. But God don't want us to fall. God don't want us to be hindered. God wants us to continue to run well in our walk with Him, our run with Him, wherever He may be. Depends on how athletic you are. Amen to that? Okay. You know, the cool thing is He's never going to run ahead of us too far. He'll just enough to keep us going, you know. Come on, let's go, kids. Amen to that. Yeah, that's good stuff. All right. Gentleness, self-control, against such there is no law. And those who are Christ's, meaning His children, have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Let us not become conceited, provoking one another, envying one another. And that's, we talk about that a lot. Pastor talks about that a lot. You know, let's not provoke anybody. Let's not envy anybody like that. You know what? God has designed each and every one of us perfectly. And we have to accept that right where we're at. And just say, thank you, Lord. So what if so-and-so can do this better? So what if this person can write better? So what if this person can preach better? You know, it's okay. God has made you specifically for who you are.
That's right.
And don't let the devil tell you otherwise. It's not worth it because he's a liar. Amen to that. That's why you need to tell the devil to shut up and get behind me, Satan. Amen to that. That's good stuff. Let's drop, go back a couple. Let's go to verse 16 here again, still in chapter 5. And it talks about the Spirit. I say then, walk in the Spirit, and you shall not fulfill the lusts of the flesh. For the flesh lusts against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary to one another, so that you do not do the things that you wish. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under law. And that's awesome because there is no law in God. God has His ways. And as we follow the Spirit will direct us. So we're doing everything God's way. Amen to that? Because as we listen to the Spirit, operate in the Spirit will tell us when we're in those situations where our flesh wants to take over. Don't go there. Don't do that. Why are you thinking that? Let's go this way. Let's try this. Don't go there. Hanging around the wrong people, getting too close to situations that you shouldn't be in. Whatever. Perhaps, you know, going back to our old lifestyle, whatever it may be. There's many areas. Even places at work, you know, certain people that I might hang around with, it's like, I don't really, not that I'm, don't dislike them, but perhaps some of their methods, their language, stuff like that, I don't need to be there, you know. If I can avoid it, I will. You know, I'd rather be elsewhere. There are certain times where God will allow us as Christians to step into other people's lives, perhaps in certain situations, and share life with them. Share light. Give them the light of a situation, you know. When you're on a one-on-one situation and you're not going to put them I say jeopardy. You don't want to shame them. You don't want to do none of that because it's about love. As we share love, you just want to share with them, you know. You maybe want to change this or do this or whatever. I don't know how God's going to lead you, but that's where the Holy Spirit will lead us. So as we walk in the Spirit, we will have that opportunity to lift up people, take them to a new level with the Lord and Savior. And if not, that'll open a door so we can share Christ with them. Amen to that? Amen. That's the goal. Because God wants us to be disciples, wants us to disciple other people so that they know all about God, so that they can feel His love. There's nothing better than His love. Amen to that? So that's good stuff. So getting back to the fruit of the Spirit, through these situations that I hear, I see, that like, oh, why are you doing that? Because we're human. We make mistakes. We make bad decisions. For whatever reason, we feel like, it's not going to matter. It's like Pastor shared, you know, once you grieve that Holy Spirit, that feeling is not good. It's bad. It's really bad because that just knots up your stomach and just makes you feel about that big. But yet again, that's where we just go to that cross. Come right up here to this altar and say, Lord, I ask for your forgiveness. I'm repenting from what I did, whatever it may be. God is never too busy for you. He will be there. He will listen. He'll take care of that situation, and He will forgive you every time. Amen. I'm not a computer head, and I've told many this, but there's a garbage can in there. When you ask God for forgiveness, He pushes the garbage can button. Amen. And what you just asked for is history. Amen to that? Amen. Amen. Not even the best computer gig whizzes can find it anymore, okay? It's gone. So just remember that. God is in that business of forgiveness. Hallelujah. He's good. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Amen to that. What God also showed me is, as we walk in the Spirit, to have these gifts. Love is number one. Love is number one. And I believe this is part of the reason why God is number one. You don't have to turn here if you don't want, but in Matthew 22... verse 37, Jesus says, He said to a man, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. Like, that's all of us, right from here all the way down. Our whole us needs to love Him. All of us. Amen to that. But, and the second is like it, the second commandment. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. That's what really got me when I was thinking these thoughts, when I was hearing things. It's like, oh, I can't do that. I am not a judge. I will never be a judge. If I step into that realm, I need to back up and ask God for forgiveness because He's the only one that's a judge. God will take us to places. We're not equipped to be judges. Let's just put it that way. We don't know the hearts of anybody. We don't know exactly what took them to get to that place. We don't know none of that. All we know is that we need to love them unconditionally. We need to take that extra step. We need to say, okay, Lord, whatever. I'm sorry. I want to love this person, you know, and to come alongside of them and just pray. Whether we can physically touch them or speak to them, I don't know, but it don't matter. No matter where we're at, no matter how we're praying, God will honor that prayer. Amen to that? Just pray. Pray for that person. However you're led, or don't even, any indication, just say, Lord, touch that person. Love on them. Love on them with your love, because our flesh is really, we can fall way short of real, true love. Amen to that? So that's for sure. But through this, reading all this stuff and that, what God showed me about the love being the first one, and every attribute of the... There you are. They're here somewhere. Through every attribute of the Spirit, the gifts of the Spirit. Let me just share this. This is what He showed me, and I'm going, okay, Lord, I got you. But the fruit of the Spirit is love. And the reason I'm saying that, this is God also. This is what God has for us through the Spirit. But the Spirit comes from Jesus Christ. He sent the Spirit down as a comforter. Amen. When Christ went up to heaven, He said, I will send you somebody, the Holy Spirit. Of course, Jesus is in God, our Father. God uses all these gifts for each and every one of us. He has that unconditional love for us. Long-suffering. He's got to be long-suffering, at least with me. You know, like, what are you doing, Dan? Come on, straighten up. So he's got long-suffering for us. Patience, oh yeah. God has got lots of patience for us because he has the master plan for each and every one of us, and it's good. The plan is perfect. It's more than we could ever imagine. So he has those patience and long-suffering because he knows what the outcome's going to be. He knows that he has that perfect plan. Even though we may fall, even though we may slip, even though a brother or sister might have to come alongside of us and lift us back up, that's the only time we should look down to somebody is when we're picking them up. Amen to that? Only time. Otherwise, we need to be encouraging them and edifying them. Amen? So all these God has for us, gentleness. He's so gentle. And self-control, this is what I see in God. Self-control, if he didn't have self-control, he'd have took us out a long time ago. Well, it took me out. I can only speak for myself. Okay, he would have took me out a long time ago, okay? But yet again, because of all these gifts that he has, and now he's sharing them with us, so we can share them with other people so that we can grab a hold of them, we can encourage them, and we can just love on them more than we could ever imagine. Because love is, you know, we could go into love chapter 2. You know, it don't boast. It don't envy. It don't do none of that stuff. That's what true love is all about. And with true love, we give to other people and not expect back. No way, no how. Here's this. I'll help you. You know, I'll do this. A lot of times you do it behind the scenes. Nobody even knows you did anything. That's okay. It's good stuff. It's not that you're looking for a pat on the back. You just want to do God's work. Because God blesses everybody. And he uses us to do it also. Amen to that? I just wanted to share. Let's go down to chapter 6 now. I want to share a couple verses out of that. In Galatians. I think we'll start at verse 6 in chapter 6. Just a little bit down below where we're at right now. So, let him who taught the word, share in all good things. Let me read. Let him who is taught the word share in all good things with him who teaches. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever a man sows, that he will also reap. For he who sows to his flesh will of the flesh reap corruption. But he who sows to the Spirit will of the Spirit reap everlasting life. And let us not grow weary while doing good, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart. We don't need to lose heart. God has got our back. Amen?
Amen.
Yes, there's no reason to do that. Therefore, as we have opportunity, let us do good to all, especially to those who are of the household of faith. I found that very interesting also. And I believe this is what that, in my spirit, this is what it means. Yes, we have to be nice. Yes, we have to be good to our fellow brothers and sisters. And I think the main reason for that is we are edifying them. We are encouraging them so that when we do go out to touch the world, we're prepared, we're strengthened because we have numbers behind us. We have people behind us. We have a cheering section behind us that will be able so that we can move out and we can go farther, go out into the world and take care of this stuff like that. And it talks about what we sow, we're going to reap here. I have sowed many bad things, absolutely. But because of that cross, because of what Jesus did, I'm forgiven. And we can always come up here. We can always write it down. You don't have to come to this altar. You can, when you're at home, all you got to do is just raise your arms and I surrender. I messed up, Lord. I need to change. I want to change. I want a better life. This is not what you have for me. This is not what you want for me. So he has a perfect plan and a purpose for our life. And so as we seek that, oh, God is so good. Amen to that?
Amen.
Just like our fire night the other night, God was taking me to different levels. Just seek him with all your heart. He will show up.
Yes.
He will direct your path and he'll take you farther. Amen to that? Let's pray. Father, I just glorify you and who you are. Because God, you are our only Father. You are our Creator. You are the one that loves us more than we could ever imagine. So Lord Jesus, let your love shine upon each and every one of us here, Heavenly Father. Let your love conquer the darkness that's in our life. Conquer the enemies that the enemy that wants to take us to places that you don't want us to be, Father. We're thanking you for strength and endurance way beyond our means today, Father, that you will be glorified. So we love you and we praise you. And all God's people said, amen. Amen. We're going to get up and sing the last song here. And there will be some ministry teams up here if you need prayer for anything. If you want to come up to this altar, anything that you've sowed, anything that you don't want to reap, get on up here, write it down, and let's get rid of it. Because God don't want you to have it no more. Amen to that?
Amen.
Amen.